Hey, what's up YouTubers, and welcome back to another Toddy Walnuts Collection Overview video. This is going to be a request from a fellow YouTuber, I don't remember who it was, a couple weeks ago during one of my live streams asked me if I added any cartoons to my Hanna-Barbera collection. And although I have done a collection overview video of all of my Hanna-Barbera stuff, it's been about 3 years and I did add some series and some cartoons to the collection since then. So I thought I'd go ahead and show you guys what I have in my collection, maybe give you a few fun facts and some information about the guys who created the Hanna-Barbera studios and show you guys some of the items I have in my collection. So stay tuned, here it comes. Hanna-Barbera first got their start as Hanna-Barbera Productions. They were founded in 1957 by Tom and Jerry creators, William Hanna and Joseph Barbera. And at the time, before they started their own studio, they worked for MGM. And they worked together at MGM since the late 30s. And now Hanna-Barbera is owned by Warner Brothers since 2001, but Hanna-Barbera does own the copyrights to their catalog, so that's always a good thing. They were based in LA, that's where they had their headquarters. They specialized in TV shows, feature-length films, and direct-to-video productions. And they did a lot of short films and commercials also. Their bread and butter, their biggest names that they, the biggest cartoons that they produced were Scooby-Doo, Flintstones, Smurfs, Jetsons, Yogi Bear, etc., etc. Over the years, they had won 8 Emmys and 7 Oscars. They earned a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Their very first cartoon that they did together was the Rough and Ready Show, which was in the late 50s. And they have made over 249 individual cartoon series for television over the years, and over 1,200 hours of episodes. I thought that was amazing. So let's get into my collection here. As a kid growing up in the 80s, it was always a fun time to sit back on Saturday mornings with a big bowl of sugary cereal and watch cartoons in the early morning Saturday, and sometimes early morning Sunday as well. Here is a show called The Addams Family, which came out in 1973. It had 16 episodes. It did star the voice actors. 3 actors that were in the original Addams Family show. That was Jackie Coogan, who voiced Uncle Fester. Ted Cassidy came back to do Lurch. And Ken Weatherwax came back to do Pugsley. All the other voices were done by actors who had nothing to do with the show previously. And this is a fun little show, and I recommend it if you guys can pick this up to grab The Addams Family. Fun watch, good laughs in there. The next one is called The Amazing Chan and the Chan Clan, and this is the complete series from 1972. It has 16 episodes. And it was about a guy who went around solving mysteries with his 10 children and a dog. And Key Luke, who you guys will probably remember as Master Po from the Kung Fu series, he was the voice of Charlie Chan in the animated cartoon. And another fun fact about Key Luke is he played Lee Chan in the movies. He was the number one son in the movies. So that was kind of cool that he came back. The next one is Adam Ant, which ran from 1965 to 1968. It had 26 episodes. This is the complete series. Had some good voice characters in here. Ted Cassidy was the narrator of the show. And this was often paired with Secret Squirrel on Saturday morning cartoons. So that's a fun little watch. Next one is one of my favorites growing up as a kid. This is the Banana Splits, which only ran for 2 seasons. It seemed like it went a lot longer because it was in syndication for so long, but it only lasted for 2 seasons. This was from 1968, and it starred the Sid and Marty Krofft costumed figures there that you see. And the guy who did the theme song, I should have wrote that down, but he passed away just a couple days ago. The tra-la-la song in the beginning. And this was kind of a variety type show because it also did include some live action shorts like Danger Island, and it had some really good animated shorts in between Arabian Nights and the Three Musketeers, which were very good. And this is a cool addition. I still need to pick up season 2. I'm not sure if that was ever officially released. Next one is called The Birdman and the Galaxy Trio. This is the complete series from 1967. It was 20 episodes. And the series was later respawned, and in 1987, it ended its second run. There was an additional 41 episodes that were made of this. This is the original 20, but there were 41 additional episodes that were in. And this was directed by Hanna-Barbera themselves. They did a lot of their own productions in the beginning before they hired extra people. Next one is called Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kids from 1973 to 1974. It was only 13 episodes. I really don't remember a lot about this show, but I was glad to pick it up and add it to the collection. Mickey Dolenz and Frank Welker starred in this series. The next one that had a very short run, this might have been the shortest run, was Chuck Norris and the Karate Commandos from 1986. It only lasted 5 episodes, and they call it the complete series. It's just 5 episodes on here. In the 80s, in the U.S., there was a huge surge of martial arts and karate movies, and I think a lot of that had to do with The Karate Kid and stuff like that. And Chuck Norris was very popular in the 80s as an action star, so they kind of cashed in on his name for this cartoon, even though it only lasted 5 episodes. Next one was kind of a Scooby-Doo ripoff. They were kind of cashing in on the huge success of Scooby-Doo, and this is called The Clue Club, the complete animated series. From 1976 to 1979, it lasted for 16 episodes. And the basis of the show was there was 4 teenage orphans and 2 dogs, and they used to go, they were private investigators working out of their house. Their parents passed away, and they went away around solving clues. And the 2 dogs, Woofer and Whimper, they can talk to each other, and they had like a southern drawl. But the humans couldn't understand what they said, but when the 2 dogs talk to each other, you can hear what they say in English. And I thought it was pretty cool. It was a good cartoon. Next one is Dastardly and Muttley in their Flying Machines, the complete series. So you can see that's 17 episodes on 3 discs. The show came out in 1969 and 70. It starred the great Paul Winchell and Don Messick. And those 2 guys did every single voice in this series. Just 2 voice actors did every voice. And of course, there's Dick Dastardly, who was a villain, always trying to get over on people. And the dog was Muttley, and he always had that kind of that wheezy laugh. He laughed all the time. This was a great show. The next one here is called Devlin, which came out in 1974 and ran through 1976. It was 16 episodes. And they were cashing in on the Evel Knievel phenomena back then in the late 70s. And Ernie Devlin is the star in this cartoon. And Hanna and Barbera both admitted that they only made this to cash in on Evel Knievel. And it seemed to be a fan favorite. It only lasted for 16 episodes, though. The next one is called Dragon's Lair from 1984 to 1985. It only ran for 13 episodes, And there you can see Singe the dragon. And Don Bluth was the writer, and of course this was a takeoff of the video game. And it was directed by Joe Ruby and Ken Spears, who did a lot of collaborations with Hanna-Barbera, and they were the kind of the brainchild behind a lot of the animation and the success of the Hanna-Barbera company. And there is the hero, Timothy, and he was always with Daphne. And I'm sure a lot of you guys remember this from the arcade. And this was a very groundbreaking game at the time, and they cashed in on the success of that with this cartoon, Dragon's Lair. Another good one that's kind of a hidden gem. You don't really hear too much about this one. This is Drac Pack from 1980. It lasted 16 episodes. And in this, the concept of this cartoon was Dracula had a great-great nephew called Drac Jr. in this cartoon. And he leads a trio of monsters that is Frankenstein, and the little wolf man, his name was Howler, and he had his superhero power was he had a howler breath, they called it, and his breath was very powerful. He can knock things over with his breath. And they were always after the villain Dr. Dredd. And this was a very good cartoon. And the next one was The Dukes, and again, they cashed in on the popularity of the television show starring Bo and Luke Duke and their lovely cousin, I think it was, Daisy Duke and Uncle Jesse. One of my favorite shows growing up as a kid. And this was from 1983. There was 20 episodes. In 1983, the actors who played Bo and Luke Duke, Tom Wopat and John Schneider, they had, differences with the studio, and they walked out of their regular show for a time. They were kind of on strike, I guess. They wanted better benefits in their contracts. And so when this animated series came out, they weren't allowed to voice their characters until season two, which this only lasted for two seasons, a season and a half, something like that. So in the first few seasons of this show, there were different actors who voiced Bo and Luke Duke, but halfway into the first season, the actual actors came back and they voiced their own characters. But everybody else came back to reprise their roles, their voice roles, as their characters from the TV show. And this was a fun little watch. The next one was a twin billing. Every once in a while, Hanna-Barbera would have a show where they put two cartoons together to fill a half-hour slot. So instead of one show being 24 minutes plus the commercials, they would have two cartoons, 12 minutes each, to combine for that half-hour segment. And that is the case with this one. Frankenstein Jr. was one cartoon on the top, and The Impossibles was the second cartoon on the bottom. This one came out in 1966, ran to 68, and this is the full 18 episodes. And this had veteran voice actor Paul Frees doing the narrating. And that was another thing about Hanna-Barbera, is they had the best voice actors. And some of these guys did multiple roles on multiple cartoons. The next one is called The Funky Phantom. This is a four-disc set. It ran from 1971 to 72. And these are the 17 episodes. It originally ran in the 70s. And they had a laugh track. That was another thing about Hanna-Barbera, is they used to put laugh tracks into their cartoons. And it really worked out well. But when TBS or Cartoon Network acquired the rights to some of these cartoons, they removed the laugh track. So if you could ever go back and find these with the laugh track, it's pretty funny to watch. And I thought it was more enjoyable that way. And this one was in syndication for a while on Cartoon Network. Dawes Butler was another excellent voice actor. He was in here as Mudsy, the dog. And he was also the same guy who did Snagglepuss, if you guys remember him. And he used to try to mimic Bert Lahr, who was the cowardly lion on the Wizard of Oz. So you might notice some similarities there between the voices. And in this cartoon, it was always like Scooby-Doo, where at the end, they would always unmask the villain, and it would be somebody that they knew, or, you know, how Scooby-Doo always unmasks somebody at the end. So this was definitely kind of a, if not a nod and an homage to Scooby-Doo, it was a downright copycat of it. So, but I do like this cartoon. It's a good one. The next one is called Galtar and the Golden Lance. This is the complete series. And this ran from 1985 to 1986. It was 21 episodes. And it was definitely kind of a ripoff, I guess, of Thundar the Barbarian and He-Man. And they were pretty much trying to cash in on the He-Man success. And this one had a cool villain in it, though. The villain was always, his name was Tormak. And the heroes were Galtar, and his affection and love interest, Princess Galia, and her brother, Zorn, who was kind of a novice mage. And each episode, they would try to find ways to catch up with Tormak and put an end to him, but he always seemed to weasel his way out. And you can see at the top, it says it was a fantastic fantasy from the Wizards of Hanna-Barbera. Love that cover, love the color scheme. It looks like something from the late 60s or 70s, but it's definitely mid-80s. Galtar and the Golden Lance. And he had a, I think they called it the Sun Sword, and he can deflect objects with it or strike down foes with it. It was pretty cool. The next one, it was also kind of a Scooby-Doo clone, I guess. And that is Goober and the Ghost Chasers, from 1973 to 1975. And this dog can turn invisible. That was his kind of trademark. And he hung out with his human companions, who each episode would investigate paranormal activities. This is a pretty nice set. It's 4 discs. That is Goober and the Ghost Chasers. Next one was a pretty fun cartoon. This is called Help. It's the Hair Bear Bunch. And this is definitely a 70s cartoon. Definitely the music, even their outfits and the way that they portrayed this whole series was definitely based on the 70s. And it did come out in 1971. There were 16 episodes. And it reminded me a lot of kind of like Yogi Bear characters, which would make sense because Yogi Bear is also a Hanna-Barbera cartoon. And the bears were always trying to find a way to escape the zoo, but they were always foiled by the bossy zookeeper and the bumbling idiot zookeeper. And there's some pretty good laughs in here. I really enjoy this cartoon. Help. It's the Hair Bear Bunch. Another one that's one of my favorites. This is the Herculoids. This is kind of an outer space barbarian type cartoon. This is the complete series, which lasted from 1967 to 1969. There was 19 episodes. Travel to other galaxies without getting off the couch. Sitting in your pajamas on the couch, eating a sugary bowl of cereal, watching Saturday morning cartoons. It didn't get any better than that. The next one is called Hong Kong Phooey, from 1974 to 1975. It says it's all 31 episodes. There were originally 17 episodes in 1974, but then the show was resurrected again later on, and they came out with another 14 episodes. So all 31 episodes are in this box set. And the voice of Hong Kong Phooey was that of Scatman Crothers. And he did some voice acting in other cartoons for Hanna-Barbera. And he was perfect for that role. Such an iconic voice for that iconic character. Next one is called Inch High Private Eye. This is the complete series from 1973. It only lasted for 13 episodes. It was about a little private eye who worked with regular-sized kids, teenagers, I believe they were, and he would help them, or they would help him, solve crimes. He was a little PI, a little private investigator. Next one was kind of a wacky cartoon called Jabberjaw, 1976 to 1978. This is a four-disc set, 16 episodes. About a 15-foot great white shark who hung around with human musicians. And they would go around and have adventures together. And I really liked the animation. And there was a lot of underwater scenes that were really cool. Some underwater villains, different kinds of villains in each episode. And the colors were always very vivid and bright, and it was kind of fun to adventure under the water with Jabberjaw and his friends. Next one is another one of my favorites growing up. This is Johnny Quest, the complete first season. This is the very first rendition of Johnny Quest, and you'll see why in a minute. I do have other seasons and other eras of this show, but this was the very first one from 1964 to 1965. And they would always investigate strange phenomena and different villains. There's 26 episodes in this set. And there's Johnny Quest and his friend Haji. And there's Dr. Quest, who was a scientist. And then there was the bodyguard for the family. His name was Race Bannon. And then the little dog Bandit. Very good characters in this cartoon. Definitely one of my favorites. I used to watch this all the time. I used to watch this with Speed Racer, although Speed Racer is not Hanna-Barbera, but they used to kind of pair those up on Saturday mornings too. And it's another cartoon from the 60s I loved. So here's another era of Johnny Quest, and this is the complete 80s adventure. This came out in 1986 and ran till 1987. It was only 13 episodes. Same characters, same names. They just tried to revive the series, but it didn't really catch this time in the 80s. And then here's the newest one. This is called Johnny Quest, The Real Adventures. This is Season 1, Volume 1. And this came out in 1996 and ran till 1997. There was a total of 52 episodes, but that was with all the volumes. Like I said, this is just volume one, season one, and this is only 13 episodes of the show. I don't have the other volumes. The next one is called Korg 70,000 BC. This is the complete series from 1974. It was 19 episodes about a group of Neanderthals who struggled to survive during the Ice Age. And this is a little bit out of the realm of the works of Hanna-Barbera because they did a lot of animation, but this was a very good series, although it didn't last very long, 19 episodes. It reminded me a lot of Planet of the Apes, and it was a good show. I enjoyed it. It's fun to go back and revisit some of these. You can see at the tagline at the top, it says Hanna-Barbera's other Stone Age family, because of course they had the Flintstones, was one of their most popular cartoons ever. It's Korg, 70,000 BC. The next one is the Quickie Koala Show from 1981 to 1982, 16 episodes. And this was Tex Avery's last project. He died during the production of this cartoon. And Tex Avery, who was a phenomenal artist and cartoon producer, he did a lot of collaborations with Hanna and Barbera, going back to their MGM days in the 50s. He passed away during production at age 72. And of course, Tex Avery's well known for his characters of Daffy Duck, Porky Pig, Bugs Bunny, Chili Willy, Elmer Fudd, etc. And so it was sad that he didn't get to see this project through, but he had one hell of a career, Tex Avery. Next one's called Lippy the Lion and Hardy Har Har from 1962. This was another one of the micro cartoons where they were like 7 minutes apiece. So there are 48 shorts in this box set here of very short cartoons. They would show these shorts between before or after films in the theater, or sometimes between movies at a drive-in. So Lippy the Lion and Hardy Har Har. The next one is a cartoon that I was aware of as a kid, but I didn't really get to watch many episodes of this, and I don't really remember a lot about it. This is Loopy the Loop, the complete collection. It's about a French-Canadian wolf who's always getting into mischief and different adventures. This one came out in 1969, and again, this was another one of those micro cartoons where they were 7 minutes each. So there's quite a few. I think there's over 45 episodes in this little set here. The next one is a lot of people's favorite. This is Magilla Gorilla from 1964 to 1967. This was only 31 episodes long. It's 23 in this box set, but they tried to resurrect the cartoon later on, and they did make 8 more episodes that's not in this box set here. But it was in syndication for many years, TBS, Cartoon Network, so it almost feels like this cartoon has been around forever, for many seasons and hundreds of episodes, but in reality it was only 23 in the original. In the first edition of this cartoon, there was 31 total altogether. And everybody loves the big guy, Magilla. Even Mr. Peebles in the background there, he was always trying his hardest to get rid of Magilla. But then when Magilla would finally leave, Peebles would miss him. And deep down inside, he loved the big guy. And I think we all love the big guy. So this is a cool series to have. The next one is another kind of a twin billing, Moby Dick and Mighty Mitor. And they would show these two cartoons together to fill out a half hour of cartoons. So they would be about 12 minutes each, because you factor in the commercials during that time, you would need about 5 or 6 minutes per every half hour for commercials. So you figure these were probably about 12 minutes apiece for these segments here. And they ran from 1967 to 1969, 18 episodes. And Moby Dick there, he was a friendly whale. And he would always take his two little friends there. They were, Ron and Tub? And he would always save them from underwater baddies. And this was another one, kind of like, it would take you to a whole nother world because a lot of it was underwater. And it was really cool to watch that as a kid. But I think Mighty Mitor was even a little bit better. It was about a caveman whose name was Tor. He was a teenager. And he had these wristbands. And when he would click those together, he would go from a teenager to... Was it? No, it wasn't this one that had the wristbands. This one had, he had the magic club. And he would turn from a teenager to a full-grown hero. And it was always pretty cool to see that it was kind of a sci-fi barbarian type cartoon, and I really enjoyed this one. The next one here was a very unique show, a very good concept, I think. This is called The New Adventures of Huckleberry Finn, the complete series, which ran from 1968 to 69. It was 20 episodes. And it mixed live action with animation. And when this show came out, it took a thrashing. It took... There was a lot of critics that were talking bad about this show, that it was a horrible episode, horrible series. Even some of the Disney animators were really critical about this show, and they didn't think it was very good. But I think it has gained kind of a cult status over the years since then. And it was about Tom Sawyer, Huckleberry Finn, and Becky Thatcher. And they would go into each episode, they would go into a magical make-believe animated world, and they would go on adventures, and they would come across villains and stuff like that. And they would always be hunted down by a villain named Injun Joe, who was played by Ted Cassidy. He was voiced by Ted Cassidy, even looked like Ted Cassidy. And I really enjoyed this show. I didn't really remember a lot of this back in my childhood, but when Cartoon Network started airing a lot of these Hanna-Barbera cartoons about 20 years ago or so, I remember catching this on their Cartoon Network channel, and I really fell in love with it. It's a great show. The next one is called The Perils of Penelope Pit Stop, the complete series, 17 episodes. And this one ran from 1969 to 1971. It starred the voice of Paul Lynde, who was Sylvester Sneakley and the Hooded Claw. You can see him there. He was uncredited. I guess he didn't really want anything to do with the show other than getting a paycheck. But he has gained cult status in his life, I think. I thought he was hilarious. He was always the center square on Hollywood Squares in the 70s and 80s. He made that show what it was, and he was a great comedian. And this is a show, I didn't really watch this a lot when I was a kid, but again, I did watch it on Cartoon Network about like 15, 20 years ago when they started showing a lot of these older cartoons. This show was also funny for the Anthill Mob. There was little gangsters. They were little knee-high gangsters, and they called themselves the Anthill Mob, and they drove a car called the Chug-A-Boom. And the gangsters' names were Dum Dum, Pockets, Snoozy, Softy, Yak Yak, and Zippy. And that was pretty memorable. So that is The Perils of Penelope Pit Stop. The next one is called The Peter Potamus Show, the complete series. This one came out in 1964. It was 27 episodes. About Peter Potamus and his sidekick monkey called So-So, and they would travel through time in their air balloon, and they would join in on historic events. And Peter Potamus was known for his hippo hurricane holler, and they would always get in trouble every episode, but they would always find a way to get out. And that's an enjoyable show, The Peter Potamus Show. And we have The Roman Holidays, which came out in 1972, 13 episodes. The show took place in 63 AD, and it had a Flintstones vibe to it. It was definitely inspired by the Flintstones, I believe. The next one here is C-Lab 2020, the complete series from 1972. That is 13 episodes. And this was another good one that they had a underwater vessel that was like a scientific lab, and they would explore the ocean floor, and during their adventures they would come across villains and different things that were going on under the sea, which was really cool to see that kind of stuff as a kid. I was always fascinated by the underwater stuff. So that is a good one, C-Lab 2020. The next one is Secret Squirrel, The Secret Squirrel Show, the complete series from 1965. This one ran for 28 episodes. And it's kind of a James Bond type cartoon where you have Secret Squirrel, and then his sidekick was the Morocco Mole. And they would go around and try to investigate things, and pretty fun little show. Another one of my favorites, this is Shazam, the complete series from 1967 to 1969. It ran for 18 episodes. This is a really good one. I really enjoyed this one. It's about a brother and a sister. I don't remember their names. Twin teenagers, Chuck and Nancy. And they each find a ring in the sand. And when they put the rings together, something magical happens and they can summon a genie. It's almost like the Wonder Twin powers, right? I think that's probably where they got that from, because this came out before the Super Friends, and I think they probably borrowed that from this, maybe, I don't know. But the genie would always save them from getting into mischief during their adventures. And it was a cool show. I really enjoyed that, Shazam. Next one is called Space Stars, and this one came out in 1981, and this is, like it says, it's Space Stars. It has segments from Space Ghost, The Herculoids, Astro and the Space Mutts, and Teen Force. And each of the shows would combine to make a one-hour episode. So each cartoon was 15 minutes long. or roughly that, because they would have to find time to fit in commercials and advertising during that hour. But Saturday mornings, this was a treat. You know, you would get four cartoons in 1 hour long episode. Next one is called Speed Buggy from 1973. 16 episodes. This one was very popular when it came out. It ran on all four networks. It ran on CBS in 1975, then it reran on ABC in 1976, also NBC in 76, and it also ran on the USA Network called Cartoon Express in 82 through 90. And it was always about races. There was Speed Buggy. He could never talk, but he would always kind of beep and make engine noises. And that was a good show. Next one was another fun one. It didn't last very long, but I always enjoyed this. The Super Globe Trotters, 1979, 13 episodes. Scatman Crothers also voiced in here. And a lot of these, each of these basketball players had a super ability. Like, for example, one guy was Spaghetti Man, where he can get really long, stringy arms. Another guy was Liquid Man, where he can go places where, you know, he wouldn't fit before. Multi-Man. I remember some of the guys had spring legs and they can jump really high. So this was a fun watch, Super Globe Trotters. One of my all-time favorites ever. This is Thundar the Barbarian, post-apocalyptic barbarian show. This is the complete series on four discs from 1980 to 81. It's 21 episodes. It takes place in the year 3994. And the characters were really fun too. You had Ukla, the Mach, and Thundar, Princess Ariel, and he had a cool sword too. He had the Sun Sword, Beam of Energy. He could deflect things with it and cut into things. It was pretty cool. I really loved that show as a kid, Thundar the Barbarian. Another great one, Valley of the Dinosaurs. This was from 1974, 16 episodes. It came out the same year of Land of the Lost, which was a live-action television show. Same year, and it's just a coincidence, I think, but they were very similar. I loved both shows. And this was cool going back and seeing different dinosaurs and caves and volcanoes and all that different stuff. This was a really good show. That is Valley of the Dinosaurs from 1974. Next one is called Wait Till Your Father Gets Home. This is one that I don't remember watching as a kid. This was a primetime cartoon, kind of like how Family Guy is now, although it's nothing like Family Guy. It's much more tame than Family Guy. And this one came out in 1972, ran till 1974. It was 48 episodes, and it was basically social commentary from the 60s and 70s. Politics and war and all the different things that were going on in the 60s and early 70s, the hippie movement and all that stuff. The father was kind of an old school conservative. Everything around him was kind of changing, that he didn't really like what was going on. And I recommend checking this out if you guys like animation, you like old school stuff. This is a fun one to watch. The next one is called Wheelie and the Chopper Bunch from 1974 to 1975. It was 13 episodes. And again, Wheelie couldn't talk, so he would beep his horn and make engine noises, and he would put words on his windshield to try to communicate with his human people that were around him. It was a little different. It was definitely a fun watch, though. Wheelie and the Chopper Bunch, 1974 to 75. Here's one called Where's Huddles? Complete series, 1970. It was only 11 episodes. And this was another one that was kind of geared towards adults. And it, I don't remember if Walter Matthau voiced in this cartoon, but it definitely looks like Walter Matthau. But the cartoon revolves around these two guys. This is the quarterback and this is the offensive lineman. And they have, not only is the cartoon about football, but it also goes about their daily lives and their wives and all the different things. And it was, again, it was kind of more geared toward adult audiences. And another kind of a twin pack here, the Space Cadets and Young Samson from Space Cadets was 1966 to 67, 20 episodes, about a evil pirate, a space pirate who always tries to mess with these little kids, but he's always foiled. And then Young Samson was from 1967. It was 20 episodes about a boy and his dog. And that's the one I got confused a little earlier, but he would click his armbands together when he was a boy. And then he would turn into that hero and his dog would turn into Samson. I'm sorry. The boy would turn into Samson and the dog would turn into Goliath. That's what it was. The show used to be called Samson and Goliath, and then they changed it to Young Samson. And each of these cartoons were like about 12 minutes each. So these next two that I have here, I like to call these samplers. They call these the Hanna-Barbera Specials Collection. And these have a multitude of episodes on one disc. You get The Adventures of Robin Hoodnik, Oliver and the Artful Dodger, The Last of the Curlews, The Three Musketeers, and Cyrano, five classic TV specials. You can see some of these stills from the shows. And this one was called the Hanna-Barbera Christmas Classics Collection. The Town Santa Forgot, A Christmas Story, and Casper's First Christmas. So I will show you guys my Scooby-Doo stuff and we will wrap the video up. Going through these cartoons with you guys really brings back a lot of memories, a lot of childhood nostalgia of watching these with my brother as kids and really enjoying a lot of these cartoons. And I had so many favorites over the years. But I think my all-time favorite cartoon is Scooby-Doo, Where Are You? From 1969. And this is the complete first and second season in this box set. Has 25 episodes from the original TV series. Comes in this little digipack. I also got Scooby-Doo, Where Are You? The complete third season. And this show has been in syndication for decades. You would think it had maybe 20 or more seasons for this show, but it only had the original three seasons for Scooby-Doo, Where Are You? And here are 16 episodes on two discs from season three. I also got the Golden Collection for the best of the new Scooby-Doo movies. And in this one, you get 15 celebrity-packed episodes from the original one-hour TV show. I also have a couple of Blu-rays, and this one is called the New Scooby-Doo Movies, the almost complete collection on Blu-ray. And you can see that there are some really good guest stars. Lower left corner, you have the Three Stooges, Carol Channing, we have Laurel and Hardy, Sonny and Cher, that is Don Knotts, Batman and Robin, and Jerry Reed. So I'm glad to have that on Blu-ray. And then this was kind of a more modern version of Scooby-Doo and the gang. This is Scooby-Doo and Kiss, Rock and Roll Mystery original movie. Now I have a little stack here of a lot of this stuff went direct to video, and some of these are kind of beat up, but I got these in lots. I paid almost nothing for these, but I'm going to include this with the Scooby-Doo stuff, and these are in no particular order. This is Scooby-Doo Goes Hollywood. Scooby-Doo and the Reluctant Werewolf. Notice the old snapper case. This is from What's New Scooby-Doo. This is four episodes. Root Scary Six. We have What's New Scooby-Doo, the complete first season. 13 episodes on two discs. What's New Scooby-Doo, complete season two. 13 episodes on two discs. 13 Ghosts of Scooby-Doo, the complete series. Scooby-Doo Mystery Incorporated, the complete season one, 4 discs, 26 episodes. Scooby-Doo and the Alien Invaders. What's New Scooby-Doo TV episodes, Monster Matinee. Scooby-Doo and the Goblin King, original movie. Scooby-Doo and the Pirates, full-length movie. Scooby-Doo on Zombie Island. What's New Scooby-Doo Volume 4, Merry Scary Holiday. Scooby-Doo meets Batman. Scooby-Doo Abracadabra Doo, original movie. Scooby-Doo and the Samurai Sword, original movie. So that was it, guys. Let me know what are some of your favorites. Also, if you want to let me know what I should add to my collection, I'm always open for suggestions. If you made it this far in the video, thank you very much. Comment below and say pimp. That way I know you made it all the way through. I always do enjoy hearing from you guys, so if you want to talk about anything down below, please leave a comment. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. I enjoyed going through memory lane here with you guys. Other than that, let me know what your favorite cartoons were from Hanna-Barbera, some of your favorite moments growing up as a kid, some of your favorite memories. As always, thank you very much for watching. I always enjoy spending time with you guys, and I always appreciate any time you want to come over and spend on my channel. I know there's hundreds of channels, thousands of channels out there, so I always do appreciate it when you guys come here and say hi. I will talk to you guys later. Take care and see ya.